This morning, we'll be talking with Tosin Omoyele. He has joined Enyimba, Living Plateau United, the guys, leaders, when the season was truncated, when it was, ended and all that. How do you leave those people and you want to join Enyimba? And of course, we know Enyimba is the biggest team in Nigeria, one of the biggest, so that Rangers fans will not be upset about that. No, Rangers, Enyimba, Caterpillar, these are some of the biggest teams you have in Nigeria. He left Plateau United to join Enyimba. If you have questions for him this morning, you can send it to us on Twitter, and of course, we'll send your questions in. So Tosin Omoyele will be joining us this morning, talk about his move to one of the biggest clubs in the country and what actually influenced that decision to leave Plateau United and decided to join Enyimba. Tosin, good morning. It's good to have you join us.
Good morning.
So how are you doing this morning?
I'm fine. Everything is good. I'm good.
Okay, I know currently you guys are training, just trying to, ensure that you're ready for the season, when the leagues start. So what really prompted the move, leaving Plateau United to Enyimba on that 2-year deal?
Yes, actually, Plateau United is a team I love so much. It's a family to me, because I've been in Plateau since 2017. But, this game, it's a hard decision for me, leaving Plateau to join Enyimba. But I want also to know, Enyimba to, I'm also happy, join Enyimba, because I'm very happy, I'm very excited, because Enyimba too is not a small team, because Enyimba have seen everything, won the Champions League, won the league several times, you understand? But I just thought to take a decision just to move ahead, just to ready for the challenge. That's all things. I did not leave Plateau for any reason. I just left Plateau. I think it's the right time for me, just to step ahead.
Tosin, we really want to say thank you for taking our time to talk to us this morning. I want to ask you, now that you've joined Enyimba, there surely will be some targets. There surely will be things at the back of your mind. You've just told us all the things that Enyimba has done in the times past. So surely you would have things that you would love to achieve with this club within the 2 years that you signed. So what are some of those things that you hope that during your stay with the Aba Elephants, you probably will be able to achieve?
Yes. For me, joining Enyimba, I just want to be successful man with the team, achieve a lot of, because if the team was, achieving whatever they want, I'll also be the part of the story, you understand? By helping the team to win several of match, doing my best. I know I've not been to the environment. I know the fans over there are waiting for me to come and start training and so that we can get prepared for the season. I'm surely believe, I have the faith, joining Enyimba, just to get everything done, because, Enyimba, before joining them, the chairman told me, every season, out of their aims, they are, just to win even at least one trophy in a season. You should have win the MPFM, you should have win the ITU Cup, or, winning the CAF. And they have the aim of, they want me to go to the CAF Champions League final this season. I know we do a lot of things are possible, so, I'm not the only player there. We just a teamwork. And I know I'm going there to achieve my aim. Everything will be fine.
I think I love that, because I was going to go there. You scored 18 goals for Plateau United while you were with them, and your contribution to Enyimba, the teammates and the players you're playing with is also going to, play a big part. What are your dreams for Enyimba, since you didn't win any? You didn't really win much with Plateau United, but Enyimba, a team that we know that can really win our trophies.
Yes, Alan, as for me, I just go there to do my job and as a striker. For me, as far as I'm concerned, if I'm scoring goals in every match, I know surely my goal will come from my team to win. Sure, you understand? I'm going there to help the team. I'm going there to make this, to make the fans, everybody, Enyimba fans, to make them proud, so that I don't want anything that will make me off regretting going to Enyimba. I know I'm going to succeed over there. I'm going to do my best for them, just to do everything for my teammates and my colleagues, so that everything will be fine for us at the end of the season.
All right, Tosin, let me just ask you this one. I'm very sure a lot of people want to know how there's going to be a lot of competition in Enyimba. You're going to a team where a lot of good strikers are in that team as well. But how are you preparing, for the challenge ahead? What are the things you're doing? What are the activities you're involved in? Are you training with a group of guys? Just share with us the things you're doing to get yourself ready.
Yes, you know, football is all about challenge when you're going to another team. Yes, I'm ready for that. You know, there are a lot of strikers there. I know, I'm sure they're signing new players, even like I am also. But everything just left to the coach. Like, you know, say football is all about the movement form you are. But I'm sure I'm going to do my best and everybody is going to enjoy me. I'm ready for the task. I'm not scared of that. But, you know, football is not just only you will do it. It's just about teammate and bond. When there is unity, you can't play all the old match. You know, like there was a certain game, you may be knocked or injury will come up, something like that. Sure you get. But I'm ready. Whatever task is coming, it's my job. I have passion for it, so I'm sure I'm going to do it. So I'm not scared of anybody there.
That's a good one. All this while that we didn't have, football is, sports is gradually returning. You know, during the lockdown, we saw some of your training. You even had to speak with us what you were doing during the lockdown. And the lockdown, of course, is over, but then sports has really not returned. What have you been doing? You know, just training or preparing at something?
Yes, like, I've been doing a lot of exercise because, you know, it's my job. It's a job that is paying me. Like, it's a job I have passion for. It's a job I'll be using to feed my family and my loving ones. So I'll be doing a lot of exercise to keep myself fit, like some programs I know I can do that will make everything so that I can get myself fit before the resumption of the league.
All right, Tosin, before we let you go, Nigerians love football. There are a lot of youngsters listening to you now, and they're like wondering how can I get to be in the league, be like Tosin or some of the other guys that have done so well. So just as you're about to end this discussion, your word of encouragement to young aspiring footballers in the country?
Yes, my advice to go to the young footballers. Like even me, I also like stick to the advice of the elder ones, which some people ahead of me, you understand. So everybody is learning. So nobody is perfect. Even like other people in Europe, they are still learning. They have some coach. They have an instruction. So my advice for them, like to just have like to have belief and just get my like this game is tough and like just be disciplined and be faithful with God. All things will be easy. You understand? Just get ready that football is a war. So whenever your coach call you out for training, even though you are tired, even sometimes we are tired. So we get to push ourselves. Just be disciplined, listen to others. Don't think you are there in share, you understand. So I'll just like, they just believe they can do it and just learn. Nobody's perfect. Learn from your elders. When you go for some people training, learn from them what you don't have. Like me now, I do like watching people. Even my teammates, I learn from them because we can't get everything perfectly, you understand? So just be obedient and disciplined, that's all.
All right. Tosin Omoyele, I want to thank you for your time. I know you have a busy schedule, but you took time to talk to us this morning. We really appreciate that. And I wish you the best of luck with your new team. But once again, thank you.
Thank you. It's my pleasure talking to you people. Thank you.